Hello again, it's Priscilla Batzell in Spring Hill, Florida at Expressionist Art Studio Gallery in the backyard. And I have a 16 by 20 inch canvas and a whole bunch of colors. My OXO Omelette Turning Spatula will get used in a minute to put some black paint base on there. In the meantime, I have two groups of colors. I have a metallic blue and something was in there and I want it out. I got it! Cool, I like it when a plan comes together. Make sure that's all out. I have some tweezers around here. You can find tweezers, nice sharp ones, on my, on my Amazon link. It's below Show More underneath the video, along with a lot of other things. So this is a purple I added, Golden's Iridescent Pearl Fine, too. I intend on scooping up these colors. And hopefully, because I laid them out early on, it won't take that long for me to figure it out. Now that blue always disappears, so I feel bad about using it. And I'll probably add more colors as I go along. I'm going to try and keep those somewhat out of my way. See if there's some color I need. Ooh, I like that. That combination is working out very nicely. It's probably not enough color right yet, but I'd rather have less than more. I'm going to give it a little bit of gold too. And I'm going to start over here with a separate set of colors so I have a different container to dip my shovel into. Oh, you know, I wasn't going to use any dark orange, but I am. I'm going to do it. And the magenta is telling me there's something in my tip. I got that too. I'm getting better at that. I want some more white pearl, which is actually white metallic from Anita's. I'm going to try and use colors that are a little bit different than usual. It's still making me want to use some purple, but there's a good possibility that this Prussian blue will do the same thing. Nah, you know what? I want some purple. So now, if I move most of these colors back out of my way, still want some white in there. A goodly amount of white. The only thing I didn't use was yellow. But I do have gold. Alright, so my choices are homemade shovel or regular shovel. And for the moment, I'm going to put these aside while I can cover my canvas with paint. Not that kind of paint. So I'm going to show you the best reason to own an OXO Omelette Turning Spatula is how well it spreads paint. And everybody's used to me telling them that by now, so if you're new, welcome. If you're not subscribed, welcome. Please feel free. I need to everybody who's in my audience to watch my videos longer because it helps my placement on YouTube, and my channel does not have the best placement anymore. It used to. I have 86,000 subscribers. Unfortunately, only a few hundred people at a time watch because I don't get good placement. But I love you guys who do. What did I do with those tweezers? I see that thing. That's the best thing. The second best thing about this omelet turning spatula isn't... The first thing is that you can see stuff in it, and the second thing is how well it spreads paint. So even if I got that backwards, you'll understand. I think I'm losing it some days. I've done this too many times. I have over 1,310 videos. So they all sort of get blended together somewhat. So this is supposed to be me adding shovelfuls of color in random places, even though that wouldn't be my norm. I'm not looking for a floral situation. The neighbors sound like they're out in their backyard. Unusually so. That does not happen often. At least the guy's weed whacking stopped. And nobody's having their lawn mowed right this second, which is awesome. Alright, so I'm not going to worry about my edges. And I will worry about them later. And now it's time to take my beautiful colors and grab my black enamel and my gold, because that's what my plan is. All right, I'm going to take a scoop, wipe off the bottom. Mm. I'm going to take another scoop from another shovel just so I can see how I want to begin. I wasn't really expecting to make petal shapes, and I'm not done playing by any stretch. I don't think it really matters if I just dribbled something. I do kind of want to turn this around. Actually, why don't I just use the turntable like an intelligent girl? I'm going to grab some more color. I don't think I'm going to use this other little shovel. I'm going to try and make these go in all directions. They probably won't look anything like this at all if I follow through with my plan, which is to swipe things. But you know, lots of times I change my mind. I like that to be a little more evenly distributed inside the shovel. So you can use almost anything to do this. And I could go all the way around if I wanted to. Backhanded even, which makes me want to do it other places. So if I let my shovel drain a little, it will do just that. It just takes a minute to be patient, not something I'm good at. Won't keep me from trying. Paint flows to paint, so as long as you've got it attached to begin with, it should be okay. I got tremendous, beautiful cells. And I'm just going to keep on keeping on because I can. Hey, that's the name of my first book on the Amazon link under Show More into the video. I'm going to tip that down so it comes out. I got to remember this for another time. All right, I'm going to switch my shovels back. Got a lot of gold in there. Let's see if I start here. What is that? Come here. I caught it before it became a real hellacious lump. I don't know what this is going to be anymore. It's definitely not what I started out imagining. And if I use a smaller scoop, I could make smaller marks. And that's very appealing to me right at this moment. I need to lift that shovel up quite quickly if you want to continue using a similar set of colors from what is coming out. I wonder what would happen if I tipped all this. I'm pretty sure it wouldn't be great. The lady with the crazy dogs must have just gotten home because they're going crazy. I don't know if what you guys can hear in the background, but it's a din. It's a doggy din. So I'm kind of having way too much fun just playing with what I'm playing with, and what I'm planning on doing is grabbing one of my Princeton Art Tool Catalyst spatulas and seeing what I can get without turning it into muck. Very cautiously. It will be purple no matter what it is. And I really, really could grab a little tiny scoop. But I got another scoop full of this out of here. And so I think what I'm going to do is just use what I've got to start with. So just let it hit and lift. Hit, pull, lift, hit, pull, lift, hit, pull, lift. That one's going over the edge. So I've got this pretty color in my shovel, and I'm thinking that I might want to put some of the other colors in it. But sometimes that's bad thinking, because I make muck that way, and I don't really want to do that. This is going in the bucket, so it doesn't settle. And I'm going to go back to using my other shovel. Look at the beautiful cells in there, and the stripes. Just gorgeous. So I'm going to grab a little bit of white from the beginning. And then I'm just going to keep doing this. Try not to have a big puddle down here in the center, but this is when I got it on. So maybe I'll move that a little bit away. I'm not even looking for the same shape. You could probably try harder than I am to make the same shapes. And once I get down to the dregs in my dish, then I have to decide. No, I got a goodly amount of paint left there. I'm not over nudging it. If I pushed it all the way to the end, I would for sure get a mucky mess. Right now, other than this mucky mess and that one that fell short, I'm still having a good time. I'm going to tip the paint back and forth though, inside my shovel. This is really not what I intended. But it's also a really cool experiment, and even if it doesn't work perfectly the first time, it's still pretty neat. Food for thought. Now, if I had more of that blue over here, I would probably... Let's see if I can fake something out. Not really. Alright, so this is not a moment where I want to do what I wanted to do to begin with by any stretch of the imagination, but I got to do something, so I'm going to just do it. Well, if it was nice, and it's not going to be nice after this, I'm sorry about that. Where shall I start? I think I'm going to start in between. Which seems safer? Little enamel, a rounded end swipe card, and swipe. And that's probably the plan, is to just go around things as best I can. And since I've got a little enamel on my card, I'm going to put a little more enamel on my card. And swipe around. I hope this works. This would be so nice if it would work. Put a little more gold and a little more enamel. Try and leave that out of my way. I'm going to scrape that off. Crisscross. I don't know if that's a good idea or not. I would like some continuity of shape. I'm not sure if I'm going to get it or not. It's definitely first trial run with this particular method. Let's go from way up here. Why not? Why not go for it? That question may be answered soon enough. Got a smaller one of those, and I'm inclined to use it. I hope I'm not sorry about this. I'm just going to put a little more black down wherever I want some more cells. I'm going to switch to this smaller card for a little bit. So far, I'm not thrilled. But But once it's terrible, I can do whatever I want to it at that point, finally. I do like the smaller card. I'm thinking a basting brush might go through everything nicely. And that could be really, really cool. Not that you would start the same way, but you might. I kind of want to go around in a circle. Around everything. But I think it's really time to think about the basting brush. So I do sell my artwork. Maybe not this one. At least not yet. I did give classes at the house in Spring Hill, Florida. Not right at the moment either. Wait till the pandemic's over. I'm going to throw my basting brush in there because I can. Maybe I should just leave my waggles. They're kind of cool, actually. Some of those cells are pretty awesome. I think we'll get to keep some anyway. I'll try and do this the way I was planning on it some other time. I learn something every time, even when things don't go exactly as I plan. And somebody's gonna love this, and it might even be me tomorrow. I'm sure I've forgotten all kinds of things to tell you guys. Like, can you please give me thumbs up if you remember? And if you watch the videos longer, you will help my placement on YouTube. As in, I might get better placement and more people might see me. I have 86,000 subscribers and only a couple hundred at a time get to see me. I think I might have mentioned that already. So that's definitely trippy. I got a minute left to tell you guys whatever I'm going to tell you. So I'm going to tell you I have playlists that you can find on my channel header. Excuse me. You can find my playlists under Created Playlists. You can find 1,300 videos there, all organized by genre or by the 100. Yes, I did. And I'm going to do it again. Flowers were nice, but I'm having more fun with my basting brush. There we go. It is what it is, and it's cool. I love you guys. There's 86,000 new. I told you that already. My books are Because I Can, and I will see you guys anon. Don't forget the thumbs up. I love you. Take care. Bye for now. Priscilla out. Are you here?
I am.
Want to see something weird?